We're back with more today on this Friday, and three guys who say they will make you believe that ghosts really do exist.
For Zach Bagans, Nick Groff, and Aaron Goodwin, house hunting has taken on a new meaning. They are the paranormal investigators on a quest to document supernatural activity. Check out this scene from the Travel Channel's Ghost Adventures.
Asesino! Asesinos!
Is there anybody here?
Oh my God.
If this is the portal of hell, well, why don't you come up out of that ground and get us raw?
Did someone just scratch me?
Extreme.
Oh my
Stop!
Oh my God.
Stop running!
These are our ghost adventures.
Wow. Zach Bagans, Nick Groff, and Aaron Goodwin. Welcome to all three
guys.
Of you.
How are you doing?
Hi, how are you doing?
You sense any paranormal activity in this?
I was getting a vibe around you, kind of. You have some kind of halo around you.
A halo.
Zach, did you start off believing in ghosts or not believing?
Well, not only did an experience make me a believer, but, you know, how can you not believe when you're hearing unexplained voices that are coming from nobody? How can you not believe when you're capturing and seeing apparitions and you can see through people?
Wait, back to the voice. You really hear voices?
You really hear
all
those
the
voices.
Like,
all
what,
the time.
What are they saying?
Well, it just comes and goes. You'll be in a certain situation in pitch darkness, and all of a sudden we'll just hear this voice come from nowhere. And I'm like, Aaron, was that you? And he's like, no. And then Zach's like, that wasn't me. So that's.
Are you ever frightened for your own safety?
All the time.
Yeah, then what do you do it?
Did you see the open here? That's what I recommend you not doing. We do taunt, but we taunt evil spirits, ones that are attacking people.
Well, you know what? There's people, some people believe in ghosts. Yeah. Some people believe in evil spirits.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Is there a difference to you guys? Because all through scripture, there is all talk about good spirits and evil spirits, and then all through literature, there's stuff about ghosts. Is there a difference?
Yeah. Well, like on tonight's episode, we're at the Castillo de San Marcos, and yes, there's a huge difference. Just like there's good people and bad people on this material world. You wouldn't want to be locked in a jail cell with a serial killer, would you? Well, do you
just
want to get
Hoda.
Locked?
Okay. Just Hoda.
Do you want to get locked in there with a ghost of a serial killer that can still harm you, but you can't see him?
Okay, so how do you know? You're in one of these houses, and it's the three of you, and you've got some kind of gear with you that helps you track down ghosts.
Yeah. Let me
explain the gear.
Are the ghosts afraid of this gear?
No, but they're afraid of us. Sometimes.
Okay.
This is, we have a scientist that works with us, and actually this piece of equipment we used on tonight's episode.
So what is that?
It's video goggles, and I know it looks like virtual reality here, but Aaron is wearing a pair of goggles. Now, inside this gun is a word database that spirits can use different levels of their energy, and they can choose different words to communicate with you.
And, I'm like in the movie Up.
Yeah. I do not believe that.
Yeah. We don't wear proton packs. We use this real stuff.
It actually works.
Well,
it actually really
it.
Works.
So tell me, you point the gun, you shoot it,
and it's
then
night vision, so he can see it in his goggles.
And then you read what it's saying, it'll speak
so
out,
what's it
and you
saying?
Can read it.
We don't have it on now.
We don't want to creep you guys out.
It's too much light. It works in the dark, too.
Okay, so you point it, and tell me you hear words
and
from...
And there's a night vision camera, so you can actually see it, and then we pump
so
it out to
what have you seen? What apparitions have you all seen?
So, for instance, tonight, you're going to see us using this video goggles right here, and all of a sudden, it directs us to go upstairs on top of the fort. It's saying, upstairs, upstairs. So we run upstairs. We're not seeing anything, so that's a good point where we decided to put up our static night vision camera, which we captured something amazing you are going to see tonight.
Wait, on the night vision camera?
Don't tease us like that. We hate that. Just show us.
Sorry. It is. It was an apparition. They said that there's a torched soldier that walks up along the decks. And we think we captured this soldier.
But, when you put it on film, because sometimes I've been to some of these deals and they say we can see it, but we try to capture it on video or film,
and
you can't do it.
It doesn't translate.
You can see it?
You can see it.
Some are harder than others, but we have a lot of this evidence, too. If you go on TravelChannel.com, we have a lot of our evidence, the big evidence, like apparitions and stuff like that, that you can actually see what we've captured. But tonight you'll see a really good
one. Do you have to believe it? Because it's the three of you, but you obviously have a camera crew shooting with you.
Like 110%, we believe it now, because we've seen it, we've experienced it, we've been there in these situations.
And how's it changed you then?
It changes your perception of life. Everything is different. Everything, all of this, the studio, everything is just different now.
You think about death. You think about death now, yeah.
Ghosts are real. It does change you.
Wow.
And it's powerful. It really is.
It is.
All right. So
if you guys ever want to come to a lockdown with us, you know what I'm going to do?
Oh,
we do introduce you guys, and we are deputizing you as official Ghost Adventures crew members.
Interesting. You have
see, she's afraid to even hold it.
Religious expression there, like.
No, we have a Ghost Adventures crew. We have members all over the world, and
is that meant to be a headstone? That's the deal.
Kind of.
Okay.
No,
all right, great. Thank you.
She's like,
thank you. Make it out.
That's great. Thanks,
you guys. All right.